Welcome to the Warrior Gamer Headquarters Podcast. Lieutenant Colonel Ken Crigliano, your co-host.
Hi, my name is Jim Poole, and I'm happy to be here. I'm the CEO of NuCalm, a neuroscience company that's been around for 33 years on a real noble, ambitious mission called changing the planet. How are we changing the planet? Our objective is to change the energy from negative to positive using advanced neuroscience technologies that are safe, reliable, and easy to use. And for the past 14 years, we've been serving people around the globe, primarily with stress management and high quality sleep. And this intuitively and obviously liberates humans from stress, which creates positive energy, allows people to have access to joy, patience, presence, good parts of their life, as opposed to being sabotaged by fear and worry, anxiety, depression, overwhelm, all the things that we're kind of all experiencing post-COVID. We're here to help. So that's what I do. That's my purpose. That's my passion. And I love what I do.
Well, I'll tell you, we are just overjoyed to have you, and we've been waiting. I know I've been waiting months to get you on here, and everything you said is totally relevant to every single person who will forever watch this for the end of time. And you said a bunch of things that that I want to hit on. First is you love what you do, and I think that anyone who gives a commencement speech or mentorship advice has some ingredient, whether it be the whole sentence or just something like that. And I really want to know why and how you came into doing this and why you love it so much.
The why I do it today and why I love it so much is inherently I was socialized and conditioned by my family as psychotherapists to take care of people that are coming out of either abject poverty or coming out of such a disenfranchised way of life. They need help. They feel isolated. They don't have anchors. They don't have people to support them. They feel judged. So I grew up with the socialization of empathy, which is rare for a man anyway, right? Men don't usually have empathy ingrained in their DNA. So that socialization helped me. You know, Ken, early on in my life, I always felt like I was destined to do something. And I didn't have a lot. My mother and father divorced when I was 2 years old. I have an identical twin brother. So it was really David and my mom and I against the world with really not many resources. My mom grew up as we grew up and then worked her way through college and then graduate school and became a psychotherapist. But we always opened the doors to people that were even lesser fortunate than us, which tells you, wow, they were less fortunate. So that part really kind of helps me in today's world of what I do. But I was introduced to Dr. Blake Holloway, probably the brightest neuroscientist, naturopath, quantum physicist, certainly the brightest human being that I've ever been in the presence of. And he said to me this sentence, which I'd never heard out loud. He said, Jim, I have invented something that safely, predictably, and quickly relaxes the mind and body within minutes without side effects. And in my career at 40 years old at that point, I'd never heard that statement out loud. In fact, I was like, what? I asked him to repeat it. He did. And then I said, what are you talking about and how would you do that? And then he explained it. And to be honest with you, I understood even less after he explained it. So it was an interesting time in life because I had just managed the largest acquisition in the history of the dental industry for Credit Suisse, DLJ Merchant Banking. And the market started crashing in 2008. So in 2009, we weren't doing mergers and acquisitions. So there was going to be a shift in my career trajectory anyway. And so this opportunity landed. And there's two things that really intrigued me. One, that statement and the novelty of that statement and the opportunity to help people. And two, who wouldn't be fascinating by learning about the brain? You will never get bored learning about the human brain because we still don't know enough about it for you to even entertain boredom. So there's a triumvirate of reasons of how this came to be. And upon reflection, Ken, it's fascinating to see. I was never a patient man. I was always uber ambitious. I was always very hard on myself, very hypercritical and just constantly going, going, going. And so why would I entertain speaking to a neuroscientist, naturopath, quantum physicist for 10 weeks of diligence before I finally said, hey, I need to learn more. And I flew down and met him. So I'm so pleased that I did. The last 14 years have completely changed my life and changed the people's lives around me. And, you know, as we can talk further, we've changed the lives of millions of people. So, and we're just really starting. So,
so let me just fill in a couple of gaps that I've noticed is you're doing something else. You're doing this acquisition in the dental community industry.
Those private equity, Wall Street banking, and the target for that acquisition was a dental company in Central Coast, California. Yes.
Okay. So how did you get from 2 years old, like no male, positive male influence, right? After pretty much that point.
Correct.
To like all of this success that we're now hearing, because a lot of people, when they hear those things, they don't relate. Because they're like, oh, this guy came from, he was given it. You know, how do folks relate to you, how you went from like zero to hero? Can you just kind of help us to fill that in a little bit?
I can. And there was numerous zeros along those challenging pathways to get to hero. First and foremost, I think we all intuitively have some inner aspect of ourselves that we know we're worth something. We know we have something to give, even if we don't know specifically what that is. And I think that's what keeps us hopeful, even through hard times. Nothing is really given to you. I was blessed with a mother who unconditionally loved her two sons. And I was blessed to share a womb, a baby apartment for 9 months in close proximity with an identical twin brother whom I adore. So those two aspects really helped. But the challenges or the external stimulation, we moved 14 times before I graduated high school. That's not easy. So I never felt grounded. I never felt anchored anywhere. I think that's part of my fear of failure as a kid or that ambition. I always felt I had to overcompensate because I never belonged anywhere. And as a twin boy, the girls always wanted to date us and the boys always wanted to kill us. And we were always moving. So we were the new kids in town and we weren't really well received. So I learned to fight really early on in my life. And Dave and I grew up wrestling right through college. And that was amazing. Part of that was probably survival. And then we got into martial arts, which again is probably survival. And also an adoration of Chuck Norris, because Chuck Norris was cool back then. So
he's still cool, Jim.
He is still cool.
He'll find you.
I also, if you want to just count your zeros, Dave and I were blessed with innate intelligence and I think a curiosity and a drive. My mom definitely instilled opportunism in our character. But I failed out of college. So zero to zero is what was my trajectory. I failed out of college because I failed to care enough to attend classes. And I did 2 years of, it's two of the best years of my life. We're talking about 700 plus days of partying, having a blast, playing guitar, doing whatever I wanted. And finally, I was asked not to return. So so how do you go from zero to a hero? I'll tell you how. You eat a big piece of humble pie. You think better of yourself and you don't believe the circumstances around you reflect who you are. So I ate humble pie in several different categories. I went from a prestigious university to community college. I didn't feel like I belonged there, but my goodness, did I get a good education because I actually wanted to be there. And this is one of the historic stories that bring light and levity to a lot of people who hear it. I built caskets to pay my way through college. Now, it never even dawned on me that that was an occupation that you could choose, but I was tired of waiting tables. I didn't like that lifestyle. I was wrestling and I was doing martial arts and I was going to college and this paid well. This is back in the day where you had classifieds and you looked up job opportunities. And when I showed up at the casket factory, it was a broken old building with glass broken. I was like, oh, this looks like the Munsters live here. But for some reason, I went in and I found a place filled with immigrants, mostly from Vietnam and Poland. And I built caskets every day for a couple of years, went to community college and then went to UMass, graduated from UMass. And from there, I moved to Boston. And in Boston, I followed in my parents' footsteps and did therapy at the State Mental Health Institutions of Massachusetts. And in the 90s, Governor Weld was deinstitutionalized the mental health hospitals, which was the advent of homelessness in downtown Boston, because you can't just close hospitals and not have a safety net for people who are chronically mentally ill. So from there, I started to grow in my enthusiasm for helping others. I started to learn more. And then I followed the path of, I knew I wanted to do something. So I did this post-baccalaureate medical school sponsorship program in Harvard. And I applied for an MD, PhD in neuropsychopathology. So clearly I had an interest in neuro anyway. I got accepted. And one night I had a cathartic moment around 4 o'clock in the morning. I got up. I just didn't feel like this was the path I wanted to endure. I didn't want to go to school for 8 more years. I went outside. I went out and sat on my futon. Back in the day, right? We had a futon. That was our couch.
Next to the beanbag.
Yep. And my wife woke up about 7 and she found me out there. She said, "What are you doing?" And I looked at her and says, "I don't want to pursue that." And she says, "What? You've been working so hard to do it. You've taken the MCATs and you've taken all these tests and you got in. What do you mean?" I said, I just don't want to. So I ended up going to Babson for graduate school. And that gave me the skills and the tools combined with psychology and having the empathy to understand how to communicate effectively so that people follow you. Leadership means nothing if no one chooses to follow you. And leadership is not a dictatorship. Leadership is empathy and understanding what drives and inspires these people. And I always use 2 levers. Are you willing and are you able? If you're willing and not able, we can train you. If you're able and not willing, you can't work here. So that's always been kind of my way of doing this. But if you want to know the recipe, it's belief in yourself despite hardships. It's a determination to do well, and it's a humility to learn. If we stop learning, we stop living. And if we stop learning, then nobody really wants to be around us because we don't really want to be around ourselves. So that's what allowed me the drive to go from 0 to another 0 to a couple more 0s to eventual hero.
All right. So when you came upon this opportunity with NuCalm, who you're the CEO of right now, you had this chance encounter with Dr. Blake Holloway that you met 14 plus years ago. At that point, you said, yeah, you know, based upon your background that you just explained to us, you said, "Oh, there's something here and I need to know more about this." And you just did something that had to do with mergers, acquisitions, and doing due diligence and everything. And so as you knew already how to do that. And so you did that with what the technology that he was developing, which eventually became the neuroacoustics that NuCalm is known for, correct?
Yes.
Okay.
Key element for me, at that point, I had already achieved success. I was doing work with the big Wall Street banks and literally handling the investment thesis, the roadshow, and running companies for some of the largest Wall Street banks in the world. I had already achieved that success. I had already seen the power and felt the greed and also felt the stress of trying to manage a lot of different people's expectations. And in private equity, the opportunity is not to change the world. It's the opportunity is to build a company and sell it. So that didn't really jive with my philosophies in life anyway. So with Blake, the key telling moment for me was the differentiation of what he said he could do, the actual impact of feeling it myself. I flew down to San Antonio, Texas, and I tried NuCalm or a derivative of it, and it changed me. And I didn't understand why or how, but for 35 minutes, I was in a different state. And when I got up, having been jet lagged from traveling a lot, I felt amazing. So the next day, he spent 8 hours whiteboarding very complex neuroscience, but it followed a logic path, which made it believable. Then the key was this. We brought in intellectual property attorneys and they did an assessment of the patent landscape. And they came back to us after a couple of weeks and said, "Mr. Poole, if you get this patent, you will own the only patent in the world for balancing the health of the human autonomic nervous system." For those of you who don't know what that does, The human autonomic nervous system manages the stress response versus the rest response. It manages human fight, flight, or freeze, and it governs fear, stress, anxiety, depression, and worry. So let's let that sink in for a second.
Is that like the response of when I'm in traffic and someone pulls in front of me and either I don't care or I get really pissed off?
That's exactly what it is. When we're in balance, we can respond to external stimulation. When we're not in balance, we will react and be sabotaged with anger or fear or confusion or isolation or depression. So that profound statement from the intellectual property attorneys, who are not prone to hyperbole. Intellectual property attorneys are not, hey, they're not marketing. They're intellectual property attorneys. That was the linchpin that made me think, hey, this is Indiana Jones in the quest for the Holy Grail. And I did find it in the hills of Kerrville, Texas, by an amazingly gifted scientist with empathy and a soul of such giving, but he had Asperger's. He was never bringing this to the world. It was never going to happen. So that combination, it's funny because I hadn't thought about this in a while, but he's passed away in December 20th of 2020, and I miss him every day. But he and I did a little gentleman handshake in Texas late in 2009. He said, let's make a deal, Jim. I'll keep you healthy if you make me wealthy. And that simple deal is what allowed us to hold hands and build something so profound that we will change the world. We already have changed the lives of millions of people. And for future generations, they will know that this technology was the first of its kind to come to our world and allow us to change our mental state on demand without drugs.
So if I remember right, he was in San Antonio around the time that a whole boatload of military members were being sent there for post-traumatic stress disorder, which surprisingly is a household term now, but was not then. No. And TBI, which I've had both. So, and I bet every military member who's tuning in here very intimately. And so Dr. Holloway was actually administering this technology to destroy the stress response, regulate that nervous system response that you just talked about to military members for free, right?
Yeah. He served over 40,000 traumatized victims, either coming out of the theater of war. Invariably, you're in war, your brain can't process what your eyes are seeing, and it never will. And when it does, we're creating a sociopathological society. So let's just leave it at that. Okay. You go to war, you're coming back with some dysfunction in your brain physiology. And there's no judgment. That's life. And the other side of the coin were female abuse victims. So his journey, Dr. Holloway's journey, began in 1990. And it began because as a naturopath, as a quantum physicist and a neuroscientist, he knew that conventional therapy, which currently still dictates, I'm going to give you a narcotic-based pharmaceutical. I'm not going to solve the problem. And I don't even really know the root of the problem. But I'm going to suppress your central nervous system. I want to share with the audience a quick equation that has never made sense, but nobody understands it. The autonomic nervous system and the central nervous system are not the same. The autonomic nervous system governs fear, stress, anxiety, depression, and worry. PTSD creates all those symptoms. So why would you think it's acceptable to give me a central nervous system suppressant to try to help me with an autonomic nervous system problem? You're not helping me. Mm-hmm. You're condemning me to a life of misery and eventual suicide. And it has nothing to do with the fact I'm being a coward. It has everything to do with, I don't want to continue to live in a state of hypervigilance where I don't trust myself, I don't trust my environment, and I'm tired of living in fear and agitation and confusion and shame. Even in my dreamscape, I can't escape it. So his quest began in 1990 because he says, I will not tolerate sitting across from somebody that I know I can help, but I can't if I follow conventional therapy. That was the genesis of the invention path of NuCalm. And then by 2009, when he was starting to have great success, he couldn't build the business. That's when I got involved. And together we built a team that was just amazingly gifted and connected in a manner that you couldn't write this. You couldn't find a CEO who's used to running companies who has a background in neuroscience that loves to learn and can take it in and be his voice box. For 14 years, Ken, I've been lecturing around the world about applied neuropsychobiology, about advanced complex evolutionary psychobiology, about stress, the anatomy and physiology of stress. 2 weeks ago, I did a keynote at the 20th Annual Congress of Brain Mapping and Brain Therapeutics in front of the world's leading neurologists, neurosurgeons, neuroscientists, and psychiatrists. That's what we do, right? So the journey was amazing. And you have witnessed the power of NuCalm. You have seen, not only in your own life, the power of NuCalm to help your brothers and sisters in arms who have come back from sacrificing their life to serve and protect us, right? We live in the home of the free because of the brave, because of people like you. Yet you come home with wounds in your brain that nobody can see unless you look at a PET scan. This technology was designed expressly to help PTSD. Now, interestingly enough, because of my background in psychotherapy, I understand the DSM-5. I know there are 7 diagnosable anxiety disorders. I understand that if this product is literally designed to solve the most profound problematic anxiety on the spectrum, PTSD is the worst profile to live with, then I knew intuitively we can help everybody. That's how we started this endeavor. And in October 26, 2009, I signed on the dotted line as chairman of the board, president and CEO of an enterprise that had no value. In fact, it had $367,000 of debt. So we were functionally insolvent and we had no product to package up. We had science, history, research, clinical proof, and a desire to help people.
That's incredibly amazing. I'm actually coincidentally learning about all of this stuff right now. We're in our neurology and psychiatry block here in med school. And I do agree with you. Everything you said is just music to my ears. It really speaks to the trajectory of neuroscience and the field of psychotherapy in the future. But I imagine that with every form of psychotherapy, with every new thing that is designed to solve a problem, naturally, even as far as your NuCalm can go, there's going to be some skepticism within parts of the medical community or even parts of general society. So my question is, how do you overcome that skepticism? What do you do to help convince the people that this is a technology that is designed to help people and it's not just a quick gimmick?
You don't convince the skeptic with words. You may have some street credibility through our patents, through the FDA classic medical device, through Health Canada, through the military approval. Little things like we've done over 2 million surgical procedures replacing general anesthesia, people being operated on listening to physics. Okay, that sounds incredible. That may dent the skepticism. Skepticism is completely ameliorated when you try it. Because when you try NuCalm Rescue or power nap, and we suspend your brainwave function in theta just above sleep, and you reach this hypnagogic dissociative state of lucid dreaming, there's no, hey, that didn't work, because you lose sense of time. And when you get up, you have a mental acuity and a physical relaxation response that didn't exist prior to that. So it is definitely an experiential piece of the puzzle. You bring up a good point, and the point is well taken. And I think that skepticism is conditioning. We're not born skeptical. We're also not born fearful. The only fear that an infant has is fear of falling. That's called self-preservation and survival. We learn all our other fears, but we also learn skepticism. Why do we learn skepticism? Because there are a million companies in capitalist societies trying to sell us shit that doesn't work. Sell me hope. Don't give me a solution. So here's what we did. And it wasn't because I wanted to. It was because we had to. NuCalm is a very complex neuroscience. You won't learn about NuCalm and the science that we do in medical school. We're light years beyond that. But the complexity of the brain demands a complex solution. And we use biochemistry and quantum physics and electromedicine. We use a whole variety of stuff. And one of the blessings of Blake's brain and humility, he was never pegged to any discrete aspect of medicine. And medicine is so vertical and siloed. hey, I'm really good at transcranial direct current stimulation, or I'm really good at biochemistry. He was really good at solving a problem. And what he wanted to do was he wanted to find a way to effectively manage your brainwave function. So I'm going to share with your audience something really fascinating to me. And I think you'll find it fascinating too. Since the dawn of mankind, since we were knuckle dragging in caveman times, we have always either discovered, created, and developed ways to change our mental state, all external. So today, 2023, if I want to feel excited, I will drink a cup of coffee, espresso, Monster Energy, 5-Hour Energy, Red Bull. If I want to feel sedated, I'll have a glass of wine. If I want to explore my psyche, I'll experiment with psychiatric or drugs, recreational drugs. If I don't want to feel depressed, I'll take an antidepressant. If I don't want to feel anxious, I'll take an anti-anxiety. If I have trouble sleeping, I'll take a sleeping pill. So think about how complex and amazing the human brain is, yet how pedestrian we are. We can't self-regulate our own brainwave function. Why is that? Well, where do brainwaves come from? They come from your cerebral cortex and your hypothalamus. And how do they create that? They're observing your environment. If I'm in the street of New York City right now on West 50th, guess what? My environment and my hypothalamus is, hey, you got to amp up. If I'm in my office and it's starting to get sundown, hey, you don't have to amp up. So we have a passive participation in brainwave function anyway. So what Dr. Holloway realized is, wait a second. I don't need external stimulation. I don't need narcotics. I don't need alcohol. I can literally find a way using complex mathematics, algorithms, and physics in a software bed and use the ears, the auditory motor cortex, to present the brain with a signal where you can literally dial up or dial down your brainwave. That's the invention of Dr. Holloway. Literally finding a way to say, hey, I am going to want to relax. And relax is 4 hertz brainwave function. So I'm going to take you there. So let me just kind of give the audience a little background of what the human brain is and how it's evolved. 40 million years ago, 40 million, the precepts and the concepts and the neural circuitry of our reptile brain began to form. 40 million years ago. It's called reptile brain because it's not very high conscious, okay? This part of our brain has now evolved into the autonomic nervous system, fight, flight, or freeze, fear, stress, anxiety, depression, and worry. And it's operated by a small piece in the midbrain called the amygdala. It's an almond-shaped piece. That's managing almost everybody's mood and behavior 90% of your day. The frontal cortex and prefrontal cortex is what separates us from primates. This is where our personality, our patience, our presence, our executive functioning, our logic, our emotional stability resides. This is who we are. That part of our brain is 4 million years evolved. So you don't need to be a mathematician to realize every day as a human, we're battling a 36 million year head start that fear, stress, anxiety, depression, and worry have. Now, the central nervous system has one primary function, self-preservation. It doesn't care about anything else. And it has 5 senses and your intuition as its tool chest. So when I go somewhere new, you'll notice that when you travel somewhere new, you're fatigued that night more than you're normally fatigued. Why? Because your brain, your central nervous system, needs an anchor. It's looking everywhere for familiarity and security. And until it gets that, it cannot relax. And when it's triggered, the toolbox that it goes to is the almond. That almond is the autonomic nervous system, amygdala, that manages our fight-flight response. So if the central nervous system is triggered, whether it's a real threat or a perceived threat, it activates the amygdala, blood flow leaves the frontal cortex, and it activates this whole mobilization of cortisol and catecholamines, and all this stuff goes to your visceral organs, your heart rate kind of races, your breath gets shallow. You're not thinking clearly. So when you think about brains and you think about how we live every day, this is pure resource allocation. The brain operates on oxygen-rich red blood. So if I'm in a calm state, there's plenty of oxygen-rich red blood in my forehead. This is my character, my personality, my patience, my presence. When I am not in a calm state, the amygdala sucks all my resources and says, hey, We don't need you pontificating about joy right now. We need to protect ourselves because we're in a threat. Unfortunately, most of us are wired to have the amygdala just dominate our behavioral pattern. And we all can see this post-COVID because everybody's holding on by a thread and most resources are driven by the amygdala. You know, I've heard this term before many times, pea brain. He has a pea brain. I think it's speaking to someone with low intellect. It's really almond brain, man. We are literally huge, awesome human beings being managed by an almond. That's insanity to me. So when we understand this landscape, and it's pretty sad indictment on society and culture that everyone listening to this doesn't even know what I just explained. That's the landscape of being human. That's the chessboard that we are operating every day on. And I'll give you one more example of the complexity and challenge of being human. In the morning, cortisol, the stress hormone, is at its highest level. Why? Because it needs to activate your brainwave function out of delta, which is the slowest brainwave form. Okay, fair enough. And then when your eyes open, the first aspect of your brain that awakens is the almond, the amygdala. When you woke up this morning, Ken, I'm pretty sure that your soul didn't say, Ken, you're amazing. I love you. People appreciate you. Let me wrap a whole bucket of gratitude around you. You are literally an angel, a saint, and people love you. No, it didn't do that. The amygdala said, Ken, what didn't you do yesterday? Who's disappointed in you? What do your kids need? What's going on? And we race. It's the amygdala leading the charge. And unfortunately, the pedestrian evolution of the man's brain and woman's brain has not kept up with technology. The advancement and acceleration of technology has blown away the evolution of our brain chemistry. And we're still suffering the consequence of being knuckle-dragging cavemen, being dominated by an almond, when we really should be at higher consciousness in a responsive state. NuCalm and this advanced physics modality presents oxygen to the frontal cortex and changes the game and puts the amygdala in the corner where it always belonged.
Okay. All right. There's so much there. First, Bilal, you're in medical school. How many zeros to heroes to zero to zero have you experienced so far? And it's okay to say no, none.
Not too many zeros. I think most of the zeros to zeros to zeros happened before. Like for personally, I know a lot of students who have struggled in medical school, whereas I was the type of student who struggled in high school. I still tell everybody high school was harder for me than undergrad, which was harder than medical school. Most people look at me funny, but my slice of humble pie was served to me at an early age. Now, if I didn't have that, it would have been me in undergrad. If I didn't have that, it would have been me in medical school. So at some point, I had to face it. So that's what happened to me. So far, I've been doing just fine.
Good. Yeah, I got kicked out of high schools and a whole entire county. So I was hit in the face with my humble pie. Like,
some people may see that as hero. That's impressive. So, getting kicked out of a county is that's an honor.
How do you do that?
You got to try hard for that, folks. So. But, you know, my college and experience was like Jim, like I was on a mission, like I know where I came from. I was like, I'm not going to fail. So that's a common thread with our guests. All of them have gone to zero to zero to zero to hero to zero multiple times. And, you know, if you're stuck in there right now, folks, and you're tuned in, like you just got to stay the course and believe in yourself, because there's always another side that you'll come out on. So
if you're stuck in zero right now, ladies and gentlemen, let me share with you something that I know is near and dear to Ken's heart. Life in this planet is vibration. It's resonance. It's oscillation. I know it's hard for people to understand, but we are vibrating at a frequency all the time. And this is hard for me to understand. Even inanimate objects oscillate at a frequency, like a lamp or a chair or this bottle. That's hard for my brain to comprehend. But we are all vibration. Have you ever noticed that in photographs, your spouse or your kids or your friends, they never look the same? You always look a little different. That's vibration. We are always vibrating. One of the challenges and one of the myths of humanity is achieving perfection or a goal. Yes, it's good to achieve goals and strive for goals, but it's not the end point. The only end point is death, right? For this lifetime. So vibration and understanding vibration is really important for all of us, because you're never that good and you're never that bad. And we're constantly in a state of flow. Minute to minute, we vibrate. When we hit some euphoric place where we feel really good, guess what? It doesn't last. When we hit a place that we feel really bad, guess what? It doesn't last. So for any of you out there today that feel isolated or ashamed or scared, or you just feel like, wow, I'm really in a low spot, you may be in a low spot. You're not staying there, because life and vibration and resonance and how the earth works won't allow you to stay there, and you are going to achieve very good things. You just stay the course. You get through your humanity. One of the interesting, fascinating aspects of the human condition is we all think my problems are my own. It is such a fallacy. It doesn't make any sense. If you're into numerology or numbers, there's 8 billion people. Even in China alone, there's 1,400,000,000 people. So if Ken said to me, Jim, you're an amazing guy, you're one in a million, there's 1,400 people identical to me in China. So we are never alone. Why aren't we alone? Because our brain is mapped the same way. We all have an amygdala. We all have an autonomic nervous system. We all have a prefrontal cortex and frontal cortex. We all have this neuronal circuitry, and we all suffer the same consequence of being human. We will all feel stress and fear and anxiety and worry and depression every day. It's a little part of it. It's a continuum. So give yourselves a break. Express some gratitude for yourself and your achievements, even when you're feeling low. And understand that this is vibration, and you're never that good and you're never that bad.
Yeah, I love this. And that's one of my quotes too, is you're never as good as you think you are, and it's never as bad as you think it is. And I think I made that up, but I'm sure it's influenced by...
Much like everybody else who's made up something. Yeah, it's probably been around for...
Yeah. What's really cool about our podcast is we've had some really interesting cutting edge folks. On episode 5, we had Sam from Level X, and he's making gaming software for surgeons, which is just one of the coolest things I've ever seen in my life. I mean, it was cool. 7, we talked about Jim Quick, and I know that Jim, you've also are dealing with Mr. Quick and all the cool stuff that he's doing over there. And actually you have a partnership with him as well.
I have a friendship first and foremost.
Yeah.
Jim, been friends with him for 7 years. He has a lot of integrity, he has a lot of honor. He has a lot of brilliance and a lot of humility. And so in partnerships or collaboration, we've been a closed door Willy Wonka neuroscience company for 33 years. We don't open the doors easily, and we don't open them wide. And so I'm always kind of scouring the earth. As I shared with you today, I've been on the road 39 in the last 43 days. So I meet a lot of people, and I meet a lot of cool people, and I meet a lot of important people. Jim is a dear friend because of who he is, not what he is. And so, yes, we've collaborated with Jim to create a revolution in learning. So we have, and I haven't shared this with the audience, but Bilal did say, hey, you know, there's a lot of skeptics out there. There is. We have the only patented technology in the world clinically proven to lower stress and improve sleep quality without drugs. We don't manage your stress response. We go right into the reptile part of your midbrain, and we solve it. And we solve it every time you use NuCalm. Yes, I shared with you, we've done 2 million surgical procedures replacing general anesthesia, listening to physics. So if you have any concern how powerful this is, that's powerful. We've been working with the military for 13 years. We've been working with 56 professional sports teams, 58 UFC fighters, the United States Tennis Association, Formula One, NASCAR, you name it. We work with the best and the brightest, and the best and the brightest will not tolerate failure, and they won't work with a product that doesn't work the first time. And considering that they've been using NuCalm for 12, 13 years on a daily basis, that should give you some irrefutable evidence. But in 2015, we were awarded the first and only patent for lowering stress and improving sleep quality without drugs. And the actual name of the patent is Systems and Methods for Balancing the Health of the Human Autonomic Nervous System. We're the only patent in the world that does that. In 2021, we were awarded the only patent in the world using methods to elicit a state change in a human. So we took 33 years of science, we took what used to be a $6,000 class 3 medical device, exclusive to the military, to pilots, to celebrities, professional athletes, cancer patients, and doctors. And we were able to use technology to take all of our collective enthusiasm, effort, science, clinical proof, and put it in a mobile app, literally giving you the power of your brain in the palm of your hand. This is so exciting and powerful, because if you're on a quest to change the planet by liberating people from stress, and you have a four-component, clumsy, $6,000 medical device, you are not achieving your goal, ever. But now, as of last Wednesday, we have the power of your brain in the palm of your hand with a flexible consumer choice and a subscription that's as low as 50 cents a day. So if you think you perhaps may be worth 50 cents a day, we have a technology that will change your life. And it's ridiculously easy to use. You simply needed a pair of headphones. You plug into the app. You choose the outcome you want, from deep sleep to the highest levels of intensity. You press play, and we do the work. With Rescue, in 8 minutes and 50 seconds, we take you to the deepest forms of theta, which is just above deep sleep, where your body heals and recovers on a cellular level. With Ignite, we accelerate your brainwave function in a 14-minute journey to the peak performance area of 40 hertz, where we activate your gross motor cortex and your sensory motor rhythm. We activate your musculature, your peripheral vision, your olfactory. But most importantly, we activate the clarity and acuity of your mind to simply rely on your training. In golf, there's a statement, if you think you stink, well, Ken's in the military. In an operation, the stress and all the confounding variables can create a lot of confusion in someone's brain. When you are mentally clear, you rely on your training and you make split-second decisions that save your life and the lives of your team members. That's the power of Ignite. We have Focus that oscillates your brain between 15 and 20 hertz, specifically 18.4 hertz, because when your brain is oscillating at that frequency, you are decluttering your brain. You are peaked in concentration, comprehension, and clarity. We have PowerNap, which takes the powerful Rescue physics of deep theta, and it does it in a convenient time frame, because humans today, Ken, are too busy and too self-important to give themselves 1/48th of the day. Hey, do you have 30 minutes to take care of yourself? I don't have 30 minutes. You're making me agitated just thinking of 30 minutes. I don't have 1/48th of the day to take care of myself. How about 1/72nd? Will that do? Yeah, I can do that. So that's PowerNap. And then deep sleep is the most sophisticated. Took us 9 years of research to develop this. And you simply use a speaker in your bedroom at night, and it guides your brainwave to 0.5 hertz and puts you to sleep, like Maxwell's silver hammer coming down upon your head for you Beatles fans. So that's what we've done. Right. The excitement and the enthusiasm, you can tell in my voice. We've taken 33 years of clinically proven, patented, complex neuroscience and put into a mobile app that is easy to use, affordable, flexible. If we can't create habits with this, I fear for the future of the human race.
All right. So, okay. So you started out, though, just destroying the stress response, and you figured out that, hey, we've actually solved the hardest thing to solve as being a human. What about some of these other things? Well, let's bring people into a heightened state of performance, which is Ignite, right?
Yes.
Which I have used exclusively for several years. I have one. Many, 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 many races and events coming either off of Ignite or listening to it while in the competition. Focus, which you said, look, let's not amp people up because you'll drain them out after a while, right? Maybe it's not appropriate for studying. You don't want to be amped up studying, but you want to be in a heightened state of awareness. And that's where focus comes from, correct?
Correct.
Okay. And the deep sleep. I tell you what. So, you know, I've been very intimately familiar with all of the NuCalm products for many, many, many years. And my wife, she ran an at-home childcare center on base and military kids, we have an outsized representation of special needs children within the military. Many times people stay in because we really do have good programs. So she had many special needs children, and she would use NuCalm to reduce their hyperactivity and to get them all to sleep at the same time at nap time. And it was unbelievable, remarkable. Now she's in Loudoun County Schools, which is the most affluent county in the world. But they have their own troubles. But she now still gets a lot of the special needs children. And she has a special set of headphones and a mobile device that when the kids start getting out of control, she just goes, "Hey, do you want the music? Do you want your music?" And they say, "Yeah." And she'll put the headphones on them and play Rescue. And they're totally calm, in so much that the entire school now sends hyperactive children or out of control children into her class. And then she puts the headphones on them. And so there are so many different applications to this. We're just really scratching at the surface.
They call her the tantrum whisperer now.
Yeah. I mean, no good deed goes unpunished, but she gets the, a lot of the children now, and,
well, she has a tool that can help downregulate stress. So you bring up a great point. We started a quest to reduce the sympathetic tone and reduce stress without drugs. And in doing that, we created a software bed using very complex physics and algorithms, binaural signal processing, a pitch and frequency mathematical matrix, isochronic waveform. There's a lot of things no one understands. Think about it this way. A typical song is about 5 megabytes. One NuCalm journey is 307 times larger. So, for example, if I weigh 200 pounds, NuCalm is 63,000 pounds. That gives you an idea of how complex this is, okay? So what we figured out was the method used to literally trick and guide the brain with safety and reliability to 4 hertz. We took that learning and we said, wait a second. The brainwave oscillates between 0.5 hertz in the deepest levels of sleep to 41 hertz in the highest levels of intensity. So we took that and 9 years ago worked on deep sleep, 8 years ago worked on focus, and 7 years ago worked on ignite. It just took us a while to refine it, perfect it, study it, and prove it. And then once we did in 2021, we launched Ignite and Deep Sleep. In 2022, we completed the scientific discovery, 32 years of research, patents, regulatory, clinical proof. We finished mapping the 5 categories of brainwave function, delta, theta, alpha, beta, gamma. And we have 6 channels that you can choose from that take you to any of those outcomes. So using very complex science that lies underneath music, people think it's music. Yeah, there's music you're listening to. Music is physiologically incapable. It's an impossibility for music to change your state. Can it elevate or, decelerate your mood? Yeah, it can't change your state. So a kid who's having a tantrum, who's oscillating at 26 hertz, can't get to 4 hertz listening to music. Hello, but mathematics and physics can. So that's what we've done. The beauty of what we've done is I don't care if you ever know the complexities of science. That's inconsequential to me. What's cool to me is we've created something that's safe and easy to use, and you can create a habit and buy it for 50 cents a day and start and join the family and say, hey, I like the way Rescue makes me feel. When I get up, I don't feel agitated. The little things that were bothering me don't. I feel present with my family. I'm enjoying time with my wife or my husband. When people like that feeling and the people around them like the way they act when they have that feeling, things become better for everybody.
All right. So let me ask a few questions about our industry. So we've had 14 episodes now, and we've had some extraordinary humans on the show. And we talked about the future of gaming. We talked about the benefits of gaming, the future of esports as well. And for me, I have a tagline that is, gaming is building superhumans. when we did that Shenandoah event, and I've spoken about this before, but the skills that I saw on display, and I have been to world championships across multiple sports, not only as a competitor, but as an observer, including the Olympics. And that was tremendous human ability that I saw that I have never, ever seen in my life. And the where I see this going is, first off, in 10 years, folks, everyone's going to be using some type of NuCalm derived neuroscience every day, every single day. It's going to be ubiquitous because you're going to need to focus, reduce distraction. You're going to need to get good sleep. You're going to need to optimize your human, you know, system without the intrusion of drugs and all these side effects, because NuCalm, none of your products have side effects, right, Jim?
Zero. The only side effect is you feel good, you're funnier, and you look better to the opposite sex or the same sex. You're cuter.
Exactly. Okay. So everyone's going to be using this. It's just the way it is. So Jim, I'm interested to know your professional opinion. You've been in technology now for a while. You've been in neuroscience. All of this medical experience and all the people that you were just like high-fiving Deepak Chopra a couple of days ago, right? I mean, like the folks that you are, and Tony Robbins, you chat with, right? So tell me a little bit about esports and gaming. And if there are people who are watching this that are executives in their company, and they're like, how can my company add value like Jim? And how can we maybe take advantage of this gaming phenomenon that is capturing the world at the world's attention? So I'm interested just if you can give us a couple of your opinions and findings.
The first thing that I think about gaming is right now it's a young person's game. So you're talking about 10, 11, 12 to maybe 20. Well, what's happening between 10, 11, 12 and 20? Hormonal dysregulation and puberty. So that's a consequence and a challenge that people aren't even aware of. I also understand some of the challenges that face the competitors in gaming. They're sitting a lot. They're not getting exercise. They're probably malnourished. They're probably dehydrated. So I look to the gaming sector and I simply look at the manifestation of they're a human. What are their challenges? Just like I would with cancer. The first Monday of every month, I lecture and present NuCalm, and we gift NuCalm to people with stage 4 cancer. What are their challenges? How can we be of service? To the gamer, there's a million things we can help them with. But first and foremost, Ken, we need to balance their autonomic nervous system. We haven't seen the longitudinal studies of gamers today and what's going to happen to them in 40 years. It's not like football where they're, you know, physically banged up. There's going to be a lot of autonomic nervous system dysregulation. There's going to be a lot of immunosuppressive diseases of their gut because they're constantly tapping into cortisol. There's going to be a lot of adrenal fatigue because cortisol has a finite amount of, you know, it's like a tank and their tank's going to be empty. We can help the gamer today because we can give them a technology that gives them a 20 to 30 minute reboot and just balances their autonomic nervous system so they're not firing on catecholamines and cortisol all the time. Can you imagine you're a brainiac and you're a professional. When you are in the zone, you are in a calm state of relaxation with a tuned in mental acuity. That's where we want these kids to get to. Not feeling anxious or, oh, that person just missed me, or that person's better than me, or that person has, you know, these are also kids. Remember when you were a kid, how competitive you were in sports and you're sizing up everybody, you're intimidating yourself because you didn't have the wherewithal and the wisdom to know, hey, it's about me and how I perform. And if I perform at my best, I'm winning. So we can immediately have a dramatic impact on the health of these children, which is really important to me. Number two, putting them in focus. 18.4 hertz, they ain't making mistakes. You know why? Because there's no room for clutter. The brain gets cluttered, not by external stimulation. The brain gets cluttered with your itty bitty shitty committee. That little committee that lies behind our eyes that tells us we're no good, we're insecure, we're not going to be successful. That itty bitty shitty committee we all have. Well, that's what clutters our brain. At 18.4 hertz, there is no room for any clutter. So that clarity allows them to think even faster. I think what was cool when I heard you were giddy after the Shenandoah event, because you were like, what I witnessed is this cognitive ascension into this super species ability to have an incredible reflexology. That's amazing. So cognitively, these folks are gifted. We can make them even more gifted. And then if they need that spike, we can do Ignite. So it's a health conscious attitude to help these kids stay healthy, so they're not sacrificing their future and their future lifestyle by giving all they have today and living a strange lifestyle where they're sitting and their necks getting crazy and their hands, whatever's going on, it's not going to be positive. We haven't evolved for people to be gamers of the human condition. It's not going to be positive. We know that. So we can help them, number one. Number two, we can improve their performance. Ignite for that kick of the energy and really high-end intensity. Focus for the long-term endurance games. And then deep sleep at night. That's what excites me about these kids, the opportunity to help them and to give them some semblance of support emotionally, psychologically, and physically while they're challenging themselves to achieve greatness in a highly competitive and burgeoning market.
That just sounds super promising. Music to my ears, because we talked extensively about a process-oriented mindset. What you're hinting at is a different type of process, because what we've been seeing in gaming is that, you're right, it is very much mostly a young man's game, and there's not a lot of guidance in the same way that, you know, when I play basketball, I could look up to, you know, the late Kobe Bryant, and you can look up to LeBron James, these older players, and even further back, we can look to Michael Jordan, et cetera, et cetera. You have all these examples.
Don't forget Larry Bird, Bilal. I'm a Celtics fan.
Larry Bird, yes. I'm a West Coast, so I'm going to stick with Kobe Bryant here as my go-to, but no disrespect. Larry Bird's fascinating, but when you look at other sports, you see that there is a legacy. And with gaming, that legacy has not yet been created yet. And the legacy that has been established is largely done by these late teens, early 20-somethings, and then suddenly they disappear, they retire, their health diminishes, they have to take time off, and then it's gone to the wind. And then the next group of young people comes and take over. And so it's this cycling of young people without a very stable set of guidance. And that is what I believe is completely lacking within the esports industry. And I think if NuCalm has the solution to that, which appear seems like it does, it can really revolutionize the longevity of the esports industry, as well as the players inside and outside of it.
You're absolutely correct. And this is really about doing the right thing when no one's looking. Do I think a 14, 15-year-old kid who's really starting to feel his oats and become really popular, do I think he's going to be easily managed when it comes to health and wellness and balance of the autonomic nervous system? No, I don't. That's why it's so easy to use, and it's almost trickery. Just put this on, dude. Listen to Focus. Okay, what's that? Just put it on. So it's us, as the parental guidance, as the people that do have wisdom and the people that do want to take care of these kids. Because you're right, this can't just be a meat factory where we're grinding out these kids that just go away in the shadows and suffer. Can you imagine if you're a gamer and you ascend to this great level of awesomeness and people love you and then you just go away? What happens then? Your body's messed up, but mentally and emotionally and spiritually, you're broken. Because now no one's cheering for you, no one cares, and no one even knows you're gone. No, that's not right. So this is about us as the elder statespeople, as the wise adults that have empathy and care. We need to take care of these kids. When I first started hearing about gaming and these kids, you know, whatever, sitting in diapers and having, you know, water, whatever, I was like, what are you talking about? It can't be like that. They need to have a regimen of wellness because they are human. First and foremost, they are human. Let's help them become better humans, and let's create new role models where the gamers who are successful also have a life. That's when we've achieved success in an industry.
Right on the money.
So, okay, before we let everybody go, I want to circle back real quick to Bilal's question of like, how do you convince people? So, this product will be very driven by word of mouth. It's just one of those things where you try it and you're like, oh my God, I know eight people who could use this. every person I talk to, I mention NuCalm, and everyone in my circle of love has it. And so I will not let anyone that I care about not have, I buy them the subscription for them. I mean, for $30 a month, who, you know, really, how much do you spend on Christmas knickknacks and all this other nonsense? So holiday stuff. So that's just me. I give them this technology and among other things. So what I do is I say, look, usually most people go, well, how does it work? What's the medical, you know, references and, you know, all that stuff. I say, hey, whoa. All the crap that you're putting in your body right now, you've never asked those questions. You don't go to, you know, the restaurant and look at their, you know, medical experiments on the Angus burger that you're about to eat. You don't do that. And you have no idea how your cell phone works. I guarantee you, anyone you ask, they will not correctly state how the cell phone works, but they use it. So I tell them, look, you got to use it. You don't get a cell phone until, you know, you read all the stats, but you have a background of how a cell phone works, right? Or how a camera works. So this technology, until it becomes a household name, you just have to use it. And the way that I explain it to people is just like that. You have no idea how half the crap in your house works. You know, the liquid crystals in your displays. If people understood how that worked, ultrasound is unbelievable. MRIs, people don't know, but they'll go and they'll get the
fax machines.
Fax machines
are mystical.
Nobody uses those anymore, Jim. So
doctor's offices still use them.
That's right.
And the VA still uses it.
So my last point on that is elite performers, they do not care about experiments, research, or understanding how something works. They only want to understand that it works. And the people that are using and have been using this technology are the greatest people on the planet. And this is one of their tools in their toolbox that a lot of them just don't talk about, mainly because it's hard to explain. And, you know, most people, they want fast food. They want the pills. So trust me on this, that if you're on the fence, that this is a secret ingredient to many, many, many elite performers across the globe. They are using it. They just don't tell you about it. It's not in their Instagram feed, but it will be in my Instagram feed. So you can go there and check it out. And I will reveal all of my secrets on how I've been using this to win championships across the world.
Very well put. And the one thing that's really cool is if you do come to say, hey, where's the science? We have 32 years of clinical studies of 52 medical advisors, Harvard, NASA mathematicians. We have all the science coming out of our ears. But here's the challenge. You wouldn't understand a word I'm talking about. So make it easy. Make it powerful. Try it. You'll like it. And that's it. Contempt prior to investigation will condemn a man to everlasting ignorance. Okay? Skepticism is learned. But like Ken said, if we have the best athletes in the world, if we have the top military operators in the world, if we have the top business people in the world using our product for the last 12 years, every day, we're doing 30 million minutes of NuCalm a month right now. 30 million. We'll get to 100 million minutes a month by the end of this year. When we went from a $6,000 Class 3 medical device to a subscription model, we went from 9,000 customers to 100,000 customers. We'll go to 1 million this year. So we're coming. Yeah, it takes a while. When you're building a neuroscience product and you can't cut corners, it took us 32 years to figure it out. The last year, we get to start telling people. So join the family. We're easy. We love to help people. It's powerful, predictable stuff. In the palm of your hand, you can manage your brainwave function. So Bilal can be a better student. Ken can be a better Air Force, amazing human being and athlete. And I can be a better CEO. And most importantly, I can be a better dad.
That's right. So, Jim, for folks who are lucky enough to tune in, do we have, I'm going to put you on the spot now, do we have an ability to get them, a couple bucks off?
Of course we do. At $14.99 per month, the couple dollars off isn't what it used to be. A $6,000 product that it was. But why don't we set up, we already have a code for you, I believe.
Okay.
Do you remember what it is?
I will put it on the show notes.
Okay. Yeah. So we have a code. We have affiliates, and we have for 12 years. As Ken mentioned, we've been word of mouth. Our affiliates include Tony Robbins, Jim Quick, Diana Wentworth, Ben Greenfield, Luke Story, and Ken Carigliano, Air Force superhero and a legend in sports. And so, Ken, you can put the code on there. You buy whatever you want. There's six different channels. Each channel is $14.99 per month. There are three curated packages that are buy two, get one free. And then there's Edge, which gets you our entire platform for $49.99 a month. You put in Ken's code, and you will save 10% off your purchase. And it is monthly. There is no obligation. The technology works. I'm not interested in a sample size of one. We have a sample size of 5 million. We're good. It's a matter of it's important to you, and will you make time to take care of you? If that's the case, we're going to have a great longstanding relationship and family. I often joke, the NuCalm family is the family you keep. Come join the family. We'd love to have you. We'd love for you to take care of yourself so you can be there for the ones who need you and love you the most, and they need you all the time.
You're muted.
You're muted, Kenneth.
Oh, no.
All right. You took my button now. Okay. So, Jim, that's all I got. Bilal, do you have any parting words?
You said everything wonderfully and beautifully. I have nothing else to add. It's been a pleasure.
Gentlemen, and thank you very much. And for everybody out there listening, much love and gratitude. Take care of yourselves and find a way that's not drug oriented.
That's right.
That's really the path forward. Okay.
That's right. And reach out to us. We answer all the emails, phone calls, texts, you know, replies to posts, whatever. We will respond. And remember, when you see this 5 years from now and it's in the movie theaters, it's on your airplanes, at your hotels, it's everywhere, you saw it here first.
That's right. Air Force Ken and Bilal bringing technology to the masses. The future of neuroscience is now.
That's right.